Good afternoon. Good afternoon, people of God. Good afternoon. How y'all doing? Hallelujah. Come on in the room. Come on in. Come on in. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is so faithful. Come on in, folks. There is a word from the Lord. Hey, Miss Jessica. Hallelujah. Hey, Miss Taylor. I'm gonna drop your stuff in the mail tomorrow. You missed the post office run for today. Hallelujah. Come on in because I got a message for you. And I need you to come in and I need you to share the broadcast. And I don't say that all the time, but I really do. Come on in, y'all. Hallelujah. We have been talking about, and my heart has been postured to. And in the vein of perfect love, oh, praise your wonderful name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Thank you, Lord. Come on in, folks. Come on in. God is so good. This year, we're going to know love. We're going to give love. We're going to receive love. But it starts with understanding. The word of God says, my people perish for a lack of knowledge. We perish for a lack of understanding. Hallelujah. Praise your name, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Glory. Come on in. We're gonna receive love. We're gonna give love. We're gonna be love this year. So in order to do that, people been trying to do it for a lot of years, but we haven't had the correct understanding. And I want to bless you because the Lord blessed me. Hallelujah. Give me a second. I'm trying to find my scripture. All right. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus. All right. Come on in. Come on in. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, hold tight. We ain't gonna give up now. The Lord didn't send you here on accident. He sent you here on purpose. So I'm glad that you are here. And I know the Lord got you right there where he wants you to be. Because he's God and nothing happens on accident. And he really loves us. I think we need to go back to singing Jesus loves us because we forgot about it. The world is so unloving. The world is so unkind. We forgot that Jesus loves us. And that no good thing will he withhold from those that diligently seek him and those that walk upright. And that every good and perfect gift comes down from heaven. There's still some good and perfect gifts. And the Bible says he gave gifts unto the church. We are gifts to one another. Hallelujah. And yes, we've had some broken places and some broken things and broken situations. Hallelujah. But we're still lovable. And so the word of the Lord this afternoon is that you are worthy of love. You are worthy of love. You're worthy of love. Okay. Well, we're glad you said you just got out of the hospital with COVID and your heart and lung issues and chronic asthma. And the key word you said was that you just got out. Some people died in the hospital. So that means God is still moving on you. His hand is still upon you. So we thank him right now for everything that he is doing in your life and that your life be a may be a testimony to other people in your situation. We thank him that your life is already a testimony. Hallelujah. You are worthy to be loved. I think we've used that word so loosely that we don't understand the power. We don't understand the power of love. We don't get it. We're missing the true understanding. I can't move from here because it's still true. The Bible says love is patient. Give me a second. Let me close my door. The Bible says love is patient. Love is kind. Because we haven't been loved patiently, we haven't been loved kindly, We've settled for something short of love. But the Lord told me to let you all know today that you are worthy of love. You're worthy of someone being patient with you. You're worthy of messing up and they not throw you in the trash. You're worthy of being listened to. You're worthy of someone walking through your seasons, and sometimes you make a mistake. They still love you. Sometimes you reject them and they still love you. The Lord told me to tell you thank you because you beat me to it. I want you to type that on the screen. I'm worthy. I'm worthy of love. I'm worthy of love, even if your mama didn't love you right. Even if your daddy didn't love you right, you're worthy of love. You're worthy of love. You're worthy of someone walking through a season with you. You're worthy of someone listening to your jokes that ain't funny. You're worthy of someone going through your sick days with you. Someone, if someone tells you that they're your friend, or that they love you, and they only can go through your good days with you. They only there when you got money. They only there when everything is good. They're only there when you're on top. It's not true. They're not a friend. They're not, they don't love you. Love, that's why I love that song by Life Jennings. He said the right kind of love make the projects feel like a mansion, baby. It's true. Praise God. It's true, because a certain type of love, yeah, it doesn't matter. As long as you are patient, somebody is caring with you and they're listening and they're nurturing to you. A true love affair lets me make a mistake without throwing me in the trash. A true love affair lets me be myself. I don't have to put on a mask. I don't have to put on a charade. Oh, the Lord told me to tell you, you are worthy of being loved. Your jelly rolls, your short hair, your long hair, your curly hair, your straight hair, your stringy hair, your stinky feet. God still sent someone with the full capacity to love you. So as I got quiet today, it just came back to my understanding that people are truly walking away. Walking away from the people that God has sent to love you. Because you jacked up. Okay, we all are. We all have been jacked up. Everybody got something. Everybody has something that they have to work through. And we're working through it. And the Lord will send you somebody to walk through. And what we're saying as people is, I don't want my demons to affect your life. I don't want my life is jacked up, and I don't want that to get on your life and ruin your life. And what you don't realize is that you are sending away the very person that God sent to love you with the capacity. They have the capacity to love you through your season. But because the people before them have thrown you away and persecuted you with your flaws, your shortcomings, your weaknesses, those areas that are not the best thing about you. So we're settling for what is not love. And we're running from what is love. Help us, Holy Ghost. Lord, speak to the hearts and minds of your children on today. In Jesus' name, hallelujah and amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. My God. And that's not the thing. So you said, wow, you just make me want to pray different because I said I don't want to hurt somebody else with my sins and shortcomings. This is the thing. When the Lord has sent somebody, you're not loving properly if we think like that. Because life happens. The Bible says bear one another's burdens. And it says make allowances for one another's faults. Okay? If you live in this world, you done been damaged by something. By something, by someone, by something. So you're not going to get everything right. And that's okay. People that truly love you will not make you walk on eggshells. They give you room to make a mistake, to say it wrong sometime. Okay, you raised your voice today because that was something that was in your heart that's still not washed yet. Help us, Jesus. I said that this morning. Some people have a bad moment, and then you have other people that have a bad heart. It's a difference between a bad heart and a bad moment, a bad day. Let's go to Hosea. I believe many people are giving away the very person that God sent to love you with the capacity to walk through your ugly seasons. They have been assigned to love you out of your mess. They have been assigned to love the hell out of you. The hellish things that have been put in you, the things that happened to you in your life that left you broken, that left you shattered. They have been assigned to love you. And one of the greatest ways that God, when God wants to do something in a life, he sends marriage. He sends marriage. It's true. Because marriage means, it's one thing to see somebody on Sunday and love on them. It's another thing when I lay in the bed with you and love on you. When you wake up to love, you roll over to love, you love in the middle of the night, you love in the middle of the day, you love at lunchtime, you love, you're being surrounded. The Lord will send love. And we're rejecting it because of the broken places in our heart. And I'm talking to somebody today. Literally, I felt this so heavy in my heart. And I keep seeing this repetitive cycle where people are walking away from the very one that God has called to love. Love them through the season. And it's hard. Let me help us. It's hard because the person who's been assigned to love you, it's hard because they stand there like, I got... No, you think I'm going, you're not going to damage me. The Lord has built me for it. Jesus Christ was built to endure the cross. Jesus Christ was built to endure the nails in his hand. Jesus Christ was built to endure the crown of thorns on his head. He was built to endure the circumstances surrounding the situation. Not only does the person walk away who's wounded, who God has called to be loved back to health, but the person who was called to do the loving, now they walk away wounded because I didn't get to do what was in my heart to do. Sometimes it gets to that because you can't force anyone to let you love them. But let me talk to the one who is broken today. Let me talk to the one who doesn't feel worthy of love. How do you know I'm talking to you? You know I'm talking to you because your comments say this. I don't want my demons to be on you. I'm just going to walk away. I need to do some self-healing. I need to figure it out by myself. I'm talking to you, I'm not talking to your neighbor. This ain't for your mama. It's not for your cousin. It's not for your brother. This word has been orchestrated for a time such as this in your life. My God, this word is for you. Let's go to Hosea. Let me give you Bible. Let me give you Bible. Thank you, God. Oh, praise your wonderful name. Hosea. Hosea 1 and 2. When the Lord first began speaking to Israel through Hosea, he said to him, go and marry a prostitute. The Lord told Hosea, go and marry someone whose life is jacked up, hot mess. One who is going to commit adultery on you. And I've built you with the capacity to look beyond their fault. One who is going to mishandle you. That's why Peter loved Jesus, but he didn't do right all the time. He didn't get it right all the time. But Jesus was built with the capacity to love Peter, to correct Peter, to bring him into alignment. The Lord told Hosea, marry a prostitute, one, a woman who will not be faithful to you. In the beginning, she is a current prostitute, not an ex, not a reformed, not a delivered, not a saved, not a fire baptized, not a blood wash. Marry a prostitute because I built you. I'm sending you, Hosea, my best. to love her. She's never seen love before. We look at the story and it sounds bad that Hosea had to marry a prostitute. But we don't know how she got to be that way. We don't know how she got to be in that state. We don't know, but it's not normal. It's not normal to want to live a life to sell your body. It's not normal to want to dress naked. It's not normal to have yourself out there sleeping with people. It's not normal. So there means something was broken inside of Gomer's heart. And the Lord sent marriage. He said, up close and personal relationship. Go and marry a prostitute. You're worthy of love. You're worthy to be loved. Yes, your life is a hot mess. Welcome to the party. Praise God. But you're still worthy to be loved. He told Hosea, go and marry a prostitute so that some of her children will be conceived in prostitution. Not only marry the prostitute, she's going to keep prostituting, but some of the kids, you ain't going to know, you're not going to be the daddy to all the kids. See, you thought your story was messed up. The Lord sent your husband. And you like, man, I'm still thotting. We just honest. The Lord sent your wife. And you like, shoot, I really ain't done with my player days. But because true love takes vulnerability, we're not willing to be honest. We have so many. And so we just say, nah, I'm good. Instead of saying, you know, I still got some whorish tendencies about me. Instead of just being honest, I'm still struggling with masturbation. I got a drug addiction on my back. I know you never seen it because I ain't let you see this side of me. Talking to Gomer today. I want to let you know that God has built Hosea. There are people that have been built to love you through your season. You don't get to burn their life down, but God has sent people with the capacity to love you patiently, kindly, not keeping a record of wrongdoing. But the problem is because we've been persecuted in our shortcomings, in our flaws, and our weaknesses, because we've had people that have wanted to go on and on about our weaknesses, we've been talked about, oh, you got a Jezebel spirit, you got a da 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 da. You don't know how people got how they got. Because we've been persecuted for our weaknesses so strong, so heavy, and so tough. Gomer don't want to be loved. Gomer's afraid to be loved. Because every time I got it wrong, they threw me in the trash. Every time I said it wrong, you don't even, it's not good. God is sending love, but we're rejecting it. Because we're not willing to be vulnerable. We're not willing to let somebody see our weaknesses and our flaws. No one can truly love you without seeing your flaws, without seeing your nakedness of your heart. But because you've been persecuted in that area, you might say, I can't read good. It's okay. I can't read good either. Praise God. But I know I'm a great woman. I am messy. I'm messy. I don't win the award for keeping the cleanest house. I pay somebody, but it's not my strong suit. But I know at the end of the day, baby, that's my 20. That's my 20. I got 80% of great things about me. But because we've been so persecuted, because we have these standards in the world will tell you, oh, a woman ain't a woman if she can't keep a squeaky clean house. Well, child, I must be a duck. Praise God, but I'm a good duck. Come on. You got to understand, God has built someone with the capacity to handle your weaknesses. He has built someone with the capacity to hold you in those areas. Come on. This is why a lot of women say they don't want to marry. I don't want to be a preacher's wife because we have such standards. But that doesn't mean that together, that's why two have to be merged into one. When Eve was removed from Adam, that's okay. That means our DNA is still the same. He says she's bone of my bone. She's flesh of my flesh. She has some weaknesses. She has some, okay, she listened to the serpent and she got us in a situation because I listened to her because I trusted her. He was supposed to trust his wife. It's normal. And sometimes you're going to trust somebody and they get you in a jacked up situation. But it's okay. Adam didn't leave Eve. Come on. He said, all right, well, we out of the garden, but at least we're going to be out of this garden together. The Lord has sent love, 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 love. He sent love and he has prepared the person to love you. Right there in the midst. Ashara, bring me something to drink. I don't think it's any more water, but bring me something, please. He sent the person equipped with everything that you're going to need to move forward in life. Everybody's not going to leave you. Everybody, but because we went through it, because we've been persecuted, people have talked about, oh, you fat, you ugly, you a hot mess. And somebody gonna love your little fat self, praise God, but they not gonna leave you fat. When they meet you, you fat, and they all right with that, praise God. But they gonna take you to the gym. They gonna get in the gym with you. They're gonna help you work on eating better. They're not gonna persecute you, thank you. They're not gonna persecute you because of the things that are not perfect in you. Their words, this is why I help us. When you meet somebody, you know they're your person because they don't see. They look beyond. They look, when a woman marries a man or a man marries a woman and they see the potential, I see beyond your flaws. And if you let me help you, the Bible says it's not good for man to be alone. I'll create him a helper who is suitable for him. She gonna be suitable for him. She's not gonna be suitable for everybody. That's why people will say they got this saying, I might not be everybody's cup of coffee, but I'm somebody's cup of tea. Absolutely. But we're missing the mark because we feel like our life is too jacked up. We feel like our life is too jacked up, and so we're not willing to be vulnerable, to be naked, to say, this is how I come. I'm not saying this is where I'm going to stay. I'm willing to be transformed by the power of love, but this is how I come. I got 5 baby daddies. I got 5 kids by 5 baby daddies. I got the 6 baby mamas. I got 3 felonies. Come on. Okay, that's who I was when I was young. That's who I'm trying to come. He told Hosea, marry a prostitute. Marry a prostitute. Let's go to Hosea 3. Because the marriage was a hot mess. Praise God. I'm trying to tell y'all about God and the love of God. Whew. Now let me help somebody, because somebody's like, oh, is she talking to me? I got to go love this man. Baby, if you ain't whole first, because see, Hosea was whole. Hosea wasn't jacked up. He was walking in the wholeness and the holiness. Because if not, everybody can't marry Gomer. Let's get that straight. Because you'll be out in the streets fighting over Gomer. Praise God, baby. Gomer. Here you go. Gomer, what is going on? Gomer. Hosea 3:1. Then the Lord said to me, go and love your wife again, even though she commits adultery with another lover. Let me help somebody. This is why I say, oh, thank you, Jesus. I just love the Lord. He's a good God. He's a good God. This is the thing that's so amazing. This is why you have to have a personal relationship with God, because he will speak to you about you. Because he's God, okay? Now, he told Hosea, go get your wife again, even though she commits adultery. Where if we read over in Matthew, I want to say it's 9 and 19. I want to say that's the scripture. Where Jesus said that divorce is permitted in the case of adultery. So in this case, though, he didn't tell Hosea to divorce her. He told her, go and love your wife again. Go love her again. Because he knew the capacity that he had put inside of Hosea. He knew Hosea before he formed him in his mother's womb. He knew the capacity. He knew how much his heart could take. He knew how submitted he was. He knew that Hosea's love was perfect. Then the Lord said to me, go and love your wife again, even though she commits adultery with another lover. This will illustrate the love the Lord still has for Israel, even though the people have turned to other gods to love and worship them. This is the beautiful part. Marriage, I told you, marriage is an illustration. And the prophet's marriage, child, I know about it. A prophet, when you are a prophet, your marriage is not even your own. It's going to illustrate. He told Hosea, marry a prostitute. This illustrates my love for Israel. He told Jeremiah, don't marry in this town. This illustrates. He told Ezekiel, I think it was either Ezekiel or Isaiah. He told him, I'm gonna kill your wife in one day and don't you mourn for her. This illustrates. A prophet's marriage is an illustration. So let me talk to the prophet for just a second. Don't feel bad if your marriage is a hot mess. Or whatever you've had to go through when it comes to the area of marriage, because God used it as an illustration. Hallelujah. Even in my own time of going through my seasons, the Lord told me very clearly. He said, I've used marriage and your several marriages as an illustration as how people come to the church. That's why these men take you to the altar. They say they want to be holy. They want a wife. They want to be married, but they don't want to fulfill the requirements of marriage. So they turn and go another way. And so it is with the people of God. We come to the church. Oh, I want God's help. Well, this is what he's asking of you. Oh, child, I'm just go back to smoking cigarettes. Praise. It's easier to smoke weed than it is to tarry. So I'm just going to smoke weed. He told Hosea, go and love your wife again, even though she commits adultery with another lover. Hosea was built to love. Gomer in a broken state. Talking to Gomer, don't run away from who God is calling you to love. Talking to Gomer, don't run away from the one God has assigned you. It's okay. You might have a lot of days you cry in their arms, but God has built them for that. It's okay to be vulnerable. It's okay. This time it's going to be right. I'm talking to Gomer today. Okay, it was Ezekiel. It's okay. I need us to see this clearly because God is going to send love. Sometime he sends it right in the middle. Right in the middle of your hot mess, the Lord will send love because he's God. Because he knows how much. You don't know how much a person has been through up until. Gomer was a prostitute. Prostitutes, first of all, the spirit of ugly is constantly being put on you. Come on, you laying with people for money. There's no love. There's no date. There's no, we think you're beautiful. They doing all kind of ungodly things to you. So many awful, it's the conditions are not good. You're degraded. If we look at that, if we look at this and this person walks through the doors of the church, we're like, oh, honey, look at that prostitute. No, you don't know what she's been through. You don't know the cost of the oil. You don't know what led her there. Yeah. I just was talking about this song and it just popped up on my YouTube. Yeah. It's so true. Love, love, love is a powerful thing. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, so that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. When I look at my life, I didn't want to go through homosexuality. I didn't want to be with a woman. I loved my children's father. I loved him. I submitted to him. I seen the vision. We were supposed to be a power couple. He got a great call on his life. He got out of prison about a year before I met him. We were supposed to do great things in God together. But he was abused as a child. He was mishandled as a child. And it pushed him to some areas. He experienced some broken places. And God sent me with love. But instead of him yielding to the love, he stayed on his own path. And it almost burned my life down. So I had to walk away because you're not receiving the love that God is sending. My God. Amen. And so I got to that place. Once it was all said and done, I was so broken when I left that relationship. A woman looked fine. It was fine because she was everything he wasn't. She was kind. She was faithful. She was loyal. She was helpful. She didn't judge me. But I couldn't stop right there. My testimony doesn't stop right there because God loved me even more than she did. Come on. And when he began to redirect my life and he said, no, I see that's a perverted love. Yep. It fulfilled you. It filled your love cup. It filled those broken places, but it's a perverted love and I have something better for you. But the Lord is sending love to heal, I promise you. They come with the capacity. You can cry on their shoulder. You can tell them your deepest, darkest secrets and they're not going to look at you like, ugh. Ugh. When someone looks at you and they're offended by your testimony, that's another one of the reasons I'm getting out of the marriage I'm in now. He was offended by my testimony. How are you going to be offended by my testimony? Whatever someone was before they met you, they can't do. You don't know how I got there. You've never stopped to listen. Be careful how you judge people. The Lord had built Hosea with the capacity to walk through Gomer's darkest hour, to unravel and unwrap, to be honest. She came home with STDs, I'm sure. Some of the babies wasn't. She had to walk. I'm sure they had a rainbow coalition. That's how I see it in my mind. I see they had a rainbow. They had a Chinese and mixed baby. They had a black and white baby. They had a Latin baby. They had a black baby. They had all these. Wait a minute. Hosea, this your key, that's your family, Hosea? This my family. This my family. Hosea wasn't embarrassed by her testimony. Did it hurt? Yes, we have emotions and we have feelings. But Hosea had to, he had a higher authority that his life was governed by. And his assignment was to love Gomer back to health. Go get her again. Because she know this is the last. She know this the last straw. She know you ain't coming after this because she done hurt your heart so bad. But go get her again. Woo! I'm talking to somebody. Now I'm talking to Hosea. Go get her again. Come on. Praise God. Go get her again. Love her one last time. He told Hosea, love. Go love your wife again, even though she rejects you. Even though she mishandles you. Even though she does not do all the right things. She's embarrassed. So now her guards are up. Now she's intentionally rejecting you because she's ashamed of herself. You got to pray against condemnation when you got to love, when you're called to love Gomer, you got to pray against condemnation. Lord, don't let them be condemned. You got to pray against shame. You have to break shame off of their back. You got to keep loving them. Love, love, perfect love. Cast out all fear. It's okay. All right. Well, we at the clinic again. We're here again. You relapsed again, but I still love you. Perfect love. Cast out all fear. Perfect love. Perfect love. Perfect love. Perfect love. It casts out all fear. Help us, Holy Ghost. So I brought her back for 15 pieces of silver and 5 bushels of barley and a measure of wine. He had to go buy his own wife. That's his wife. He had to go purchase his wife. God gave him the money to do it, the humility to do it, the willpower to do it, the faith to do it. Then he said to her, you must live in my house for many days and stop your prostitution. I say this all the time. I don't believe that the Lord would have made Hosea stay with Gomer had she continued to prostitute. There was a season where I've loved as much as I can love. And that's where we get to deliverance or divorce. We ain't talking about that right now. We're talking about the love that is called to change and the heart that is ready to be changed. Don't let fear keep you from love. When it's right, y'all, it is scary because it seems too good to be true. It seems, because everybody, they said to you, I mean, you saying the same, they said they were going to love me too. They said they was going to stay too. They say I got your back too. They said la, la, la too. But there comes a moment when it's real. Don't run because it's real. Don't run because it's uncomfortable. Run when you see the red flags. If God has not called you to love someone, he told Hosea, he put it in his heart. Jonathan and David, let's talk about them. The Lord sent a loving friendship. He sent a loving friendship. When the Bible says when David spoke, Jonathan's heart was instantly tied to David. There was a soul tie in the spirit. David was put in Jonathan's spirit by the Lord. It was nothing he could do about it. The Lord set that up, and Jonathan was supposed to leave with David, but he stayed with his father and lost his life in battle alongside his daddy because he wasn't willing to go with the love that God put in his heart. Everybody won't accept it. I hate that. I've had to walk away from several people because they just weren't ready to be loved. Because I didn't feel worthy. But the Lord said you're worthy to be loved in the state that you are in now. You don't have to change to be loved. You don't have to be, the love is going to come alongside and change. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. There is a power of love. It makes you want to change. That's why the Bible says, with loving kindness have I drawn thee. It's the love that draws you, the kindness, the gentleness, the patience. This is why the enemy uses that to trick. He'll allow a wolf in sheep's clothing to be loving-ish. But the Lord said he'll never have us ignorant to Satan's devices. You'll be able to see through it. Sometime early, sometime it takes you a while, but it's all right. Either way, he told Hosea, marry a prostitute and love her and go back and get her. Hosea 3:3, then I said to her, you must live in my house for many days and stop your prostitution. During this time, you will not have sexual relations with anyone, not even me. They had to fast. The Bible says these kind go out only through fasting and prayer. This song right here is so special to my heart. When I was delivered from homosexuality, the Lord showed me this video and he said, look at the picture of it. He said, as you watch the video, that's how I see you. The video, the view, the picture is how I see you. I see you as precious, dainty. Loving. I see you as my daughter. You deserve to be loved. Hallelujah. And he said the words were from my heart to him and the picture. Hallelujah. And when I look at it, it's like to really be loved. It's called Why I Love You by Major. To watch it, it really soft in my heart. Because I have been loved wrong so long. My ex-husband did all the things. He was awful in the marriage. He stalked me for several years after the marriage. I was a wreck. That's why it was so easy for me to fall into homosexuality. But it wasn't where my story ended. Thank you, God. And the enemy's job is to send love that's not truly love. I know, I understand clearly the assignment of the enemy is to send, to allow love. The enemy's assignment is to get in the middle of the man's ear and make him go to the left. And if he's not submitted to God, if he has no true relationship, he's going to follow the enemy. But the enemy wants that to be a part of my testimony, so I go back to women. But it's not a part, that's not a part of my life because I understand the window. I always say you can't just know the door it came in. You got to know the window. The Bible says it's not good for man to be alone. I'll create for you a helper. Many, many men don't let wives help. You don't got to do it by yourself. It was never God's intention for you to do it by yourself. Hallelujah. I see it over and over and over again. God sends love. Sends love. He sends love, and we are so, our hearts are so hardened. They're so broken. They're so afraid to be vulnerable, because the last time I told someone my secret, they used it against me. They exposed it. That's why I tell my own story. So you ain't got nothing to tell. You be like, oh, Apostle said, Apostle did what? Oh, shoot. She already told us about that. She said that on live. So the whole world know that. That ain't no secret. Yeah. I need us to see this. Hold on. I'm looking for a particular song. Give me 1 second. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Come on. Praise the name of the Lord. The Lord is sending love to heal, but we are rejecting it. And once you truly come into love, they're going to accept you as you are. They're going to love you through it. Love does come with boundaries. It does come with regulations. It does come with terms and conditions, because love is not going to tear down the other person. Both people are going to be built up. That's why Hosea said, okay, now I'm going to go out here. I'm going to buy you back. But these are the terms and the conditions. And the Lord said, verse 4, this shows that Israel will go a long time without a king or a prince, without sacrifice, sacred pillars, priests, or even idols. But afterwards, the people will return and devote themselves to the Lord their God and to David to David's descendants. In the last days, they will tremble in awe of the Lord and his goodness. Now, I don't like the testimony that you got to go through people cheating for 29 years. I've already did that, so that ain't my future testimony. But I don't like the testimony, but I understand it. Because when you walk through a person's hell season with them and you stay with them, it cultivates a certain kind of love. There is a certain kind of love that's cultivated in that thing. I'm trying to tell you. And that's so it is. That's why we love the Lord like we love him, because he's been there through our hard days. When we turned our back, when we backslid, and he still loved us. His love is perfect. And that's what creates the worship of one's heart. It's what creates honor. It creates reverence. The Lord is sending love. When you meet that person, you can be naked. You got to try the spirit. You got to let them see, can they hold a little of your weight? Let me tell you a little. Are you mad about what I'm mad about? Can you support me? Do you not, when I'm wrong, do you correct me in love, or do you just let me be wrong? Because love brings correction. Oh, praise your wonderful name. The Lord sends love. We can think about 1 Samuel 25, Abigail and her husband's name was Nabal. She was in an awful marriage to a toxic man, a narcissist. That's the word everybody likes to use, honey. It just means unsaved, praise God, unsubmitted, praise the Lord. But she was married to this man. He was hurtful. He was crazy. And she always had to clean up his messes. She had to come alongside. And guess what? Afterwards, the Lord sent David, and it was quick, baby. He died and David called, praise God. Oh, glory. The marriage was over and David called. Hey. Can we do this? Praise God. Because, yeah. And the Lord knew her heart needed a man that could stand beside her, and that a man who had a heart posture towards God. Let's go to Genesis 24. Genesis 24. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Genesis 24 and...24 and 67. And Isaac brought Rebekah into his mother Sarah's tent, and she became his wife. He loved her deeply, and she was a special comfort to him after the death of his mother. Many people are, you want to wait till I get through my grieving when they've been sent to grieve with you. You want to go through the situation by yourself, and God sent them as a special comfort to go through your hard season with you. Don't send away your help. Don't send away the one that God has assigned to love you. Don't send away the one God has assigned to be patient with you. Don't send away. You just got to yield, be willing to come under, be willing to be vulnerable. They're built to hold you. They're built to stand beside you, but you got to be committed to the process. God don't send love to let you stay the same. He sends love so that you can be transformed. But in order to be transformed, you got to be willing to be vulnerable. You got to be willing to be naked. You got to be willing to say, I am not good today. Not having a good day. I'm really thinking about using today. I'm really thinking about sleeping with somebody. What are you going to tell your husband that? He's built for it. Because he's going to be able to walk you through it. Babe, I'm sitting here struggling with these cupcakes. I'm just can't stop thinking about cupcakes. Come on. The Lord is sending someone to love you in the place that you are in, just like you are with your bad kids. Praise God. Come on, they gonna know how to, when they come along, things begin to fall in place with your crazy baby mama, with your crazy baby daddy. Listen, okay? When I was going through, after my divorce with my kid's father, and I was dating my best friend, which was a woman, I used to tell her all the time, child, if I was you, I wouldn't date me, because that man was nuts. He vandalized my car, her car. He was called. I mean, it was, we went through 3 years of hell. At the end of the day, it wasn't a holy relationship, but she stayed. And I don't know how she stayed, because that was, I mean, it was very, very, very bad. But God has built someone to stand in seasons, because if not, you're going to lose your mind. You're going to self-destruct. You're going to be overtaken. It is not God's desire that you suffer through seasons alone. It's not good. Let's make it a bigger spectrum. It's not good for mankind to be alone. The very one you are rejecting is the very one God has called you to, and he's called them to you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Ooh, praise your wonderful name. Hallelujah. Woman of God, reach out. Woman of God, call me. Call me, woman. Hallelujah. Miss Terry, call me. Call me, call me, call me. You've been on my mind. It's a thousand things on my plate, but I'm never too busy. Call me. Reach out, text. Get with me. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for your word on today. May it settle on our hearts. May we understand we are worthy of love. Perfect love casts out all fear. We're worthy of love. We're worthy. We're worthy of love. Talking to every Gomer out there, we're worthy. You're worthy of love. With your flaws, you're still worthy. With your stretch marks, you're still worthy. With your stinky feet, you're still worthy. You're still worthy. You're still worthy with your shortcomings. You're still worthy. Hallelujah. I'm talking to the man who, you don't make good money, but God sent the woman and she makes real good money, and you're nervous because you like the man. You're listening to society. And society tells you got to have, you're not a man if you don't make more than your wife. You're worthy to be loved. I bind shame right now in the name of Jesus. And may the love of God chase away all condemnation that is trying to overtake your heart and sabotage your situation. I plead the blood right now. In the name of Jesus, we bind you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. The people of God will have love. They will have happily ever afters. They will have holy matrimony. Lord, we thank you. We glorify you. We magnify you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah and amen. I want to play this song. A long time ago, I ran across this song. Now, I want you to listen to it with your spiritual ears. It's supposed to be a secular song, but it's Anthony Hamilton and Carrie Hilson, and it's called Never Let Go. Now, when you listen to it, the man's voice, as I listen to this song, that's how I hear God speaking to us. And Carrie Hilson, and that's the woman's voice, and that's how we talk to God. And this is not only in God, it's also in relationship. So I'm going to play this song because it blesses me. When I heard it, I said, oh, this is holy. Let me plug up my other phone. I'm about to go dead. Today, hallelujah. And that's just kind of where you gotta let somebody love you. It's not just marriage, it's friendship. Come on. Hallelujah. Somebody said, can I share my worship playlist? I don't really have a certain playlist. I don't know, y'all. Kind of just some stuff pops up. Some things, like sometimes I do have a playlist, sometimes I don't, and then I change it and just, yeah. So I don't really have a certain playlist, but if you ask me if it's a certain song, I can let you know what that is. Hallelujah. All right, people of God. Well, that's all I got. You're worthy of being loved. So before we go, I want you to type that on the screen. I'm worthy of being loved. My God. Listen, praise God. I'm worthy of being loved. Take us, okay, come on, we're going to take us a deep breath. All right. Take us a deep breath. Take us a deep breath. We're taking a deep breath. Take a deep breath. You're worthy about being loved. Okay, okay. You're worthy of being loved. You're worthy of being loved. Oh, Lord. Praise God. Okay, let me go out on Instagram because it's going in and out. All right, give me a second, Instagram. You're worthy of being loved. Though you have been broken, you have been mishandled, unappreciated. You have been mishandled, unappreciated. You ain't been treated right. You are worthy of being loved. And you're going to be loved. And God is going to send love, but you got to be willing to put your guard down. You can't be loved in a cage. I came off of IG and came back in. I had a phone call, so it sent the live out. But you're worthy of being loved. But you got to be willing to let somebody in. Let somebody get close to you. And I said this earlier on the live, and I stick to it. Even if I love them and I let them love me and they don't do right, he's the same guy that healed me last time. And something I had to stop saying is I can't take another heartbreak. I had to stop saying that. Because the devil will use it, and then you somewhere, you having a whole heart attack because you spoke, you can't take another heartbreak. I just will say it now. I just say, God, you know, because if you allow me to have another heartbreak, you're God and you're going to use it. But that does not rob me of the promise that I'm going to have what God has spoken, and you're going to have what God has spoken concerning you. When people are sent to love you, let them love you. A part of being loved is let them take care of you. Love covers. Oh, no, it's okay. I don't need nothing. You over there hungry. You ain't got no food. They say, hey, you need some food. I don't know. God put it in my... No, I don't need no food. I'm good. Over there hungry. Love covers. Can I pray with you? No, I'm good. I pray for myself. It's pride. But pride does not come without brokenness. So I get it. But it's time to put our walls down, people of God. And let's be loved so that we can display the love of God and people can see the love of God and the redemption of God in our relationships. Hallelujah. Come on. And it's so true. Someone said, God has called me to be a Hosea to a man, and he stole your heart, softened your heart. And it's so real because it's a real thing. When God prepares you, he prepares your heart for people. It's like, they like, I'm a mess. And you like, girl, but you've been so cute. Praise God. I know. But that ain't what I see. Because they see you like God sees you. Let people love you. Let people love you. All right, people of God, that's all I got today. I pray that word bless you and encourage you. It will be on our YouTube channel. It's called, it will be called I Am Worthy of Love. As soon as I download it, I'll upload it for you. And, you can share it with somebody who you believe may need it. You're worthy of being loved. Even our children. Just because you have an absent father doesn't mean that you don't have to chase your daddy. If your daddy don't want to be there, your mama don't want to be there, you just got to let them be great. And ask God to keep your heart protected in the meantime. And ask God daily, show me who you sent to father me today. Because it might be the bus driver. It might be the principal. Come on. Hallelujah. All right, y'all. I love y'all. Be encouraged. I will see you all in the morning at 7 a.m. I do one-on-one. I do life coaching. If you'd like to do one-on-one, you can check out the information on my website, which is called makeoverministry.com. Go to the life coach page. You can book a session, and we'll set up a Zoom call, and we can walk through a season together. Hallelujah. We can walk through a season together, but you got to be committed to the process. And we can come all through, because love comes through counseling too. Love comes through counsel also. Sometimes it's good to have marriage counseling, but it's good to have pre-marriage counseling. It's good to have individual counsel, because you got to get out that junk so you don't cut the person. So you don't have to be Gomer. You don't have to be. Hallelujah. And some people say, I can't afford it. Really, you can't afford not to. It's going to be a sacrifice, but it's worth it. Promise you, it's worth it to have someone sit down and unpack your heart That's why it is a blessing when someone sends my spiritual children. They're like, I don't want to bother you. Listen, you better bother me while I'm here, because I'm sent. I'm sent on assignment to love the hell out of your heart, so that when people come, you're not so busy rejecting love that you miss what God is sending. Hallelujah. Oh, God is faithful. Thank you, Lord. I don't know. We may be in this vein for a little while, because we got to learn this as the people of God. My heart has been very heavy for children, you know, and how they have parents that walk away, and then you have parents that, you have people that want to have kids and they don't have kids. But we have people that walk away and don't do right by their kids. But you have to teach your child, you're still worthy of love, and it's not your fault, and it's not your loss, it's their loss. It's not your fault if they're not there for whatever reason. For whatever reason. And many people say, I seen something where this man was on there today, and he was saying his mama kept him from his daddy or something. You know, at the end of the day, we still, when it's mine, I'm coming for it. Praise God. Yeah. However, I'm going to fight in the natural, I'm going to fight in the spiritual, I'm going to fight all, because it's mine. Because we don't stop. When we're trying to get the Jordans, when we're trying to get the car, we're trying to get the good weed, we're trying to get the liquor, we're trying to get the women, we're relentless when it comes to everything else. So you can't say a person has stopped you. There's always a way. If I got to write letters to them, you're going to know that I tried to be there to the best of my ability, because you minds. Oh, praise your wonderful name. So to my Gomers, let them love you. To Hosea, keep loving. And let's let God be God. I love you all. Have a good day. And I'll see y'all in the morning at 7 a.m., Lord willing. God bless. I'm Apostle Julia, and this is the Makeover Ministry.